this video, how to do ground check to stop player multi-jump. Using collision enter and exit. How to stop player jump over the wall. With ground check at feet only. How to get or set variables from another C# script. What is collider is trigger. And how to use collider on trigger events. How to fix issue walk on wall. Using physic material. This works perfect on any terrain, any 2D or 3D games. In last video, we made player can move around and jump. But if you press button jump many times, player will do multi-jump. Or can walk at middle of air. To fix it, today we make player can jump, only if he stands on ground. Or standing on other objects. Open our player controller script. Let's create a new public variable with type is bool. And its name on ground. Any initial values, false or true. Player can press button jump only if player is on ground. When variable on ground is true. Let's go to code of button jump. When button space is pressed down, event input get key down will be true. The code is the same like this. If you want to add one more condition to compare, use double ampersand. Button space compressed only if variable on ground equals true. When player is on ground and press jump, it will do event add force. To make player jump. In last video, we added collider on our player object. And we added another collider on object ground also. When collider of player touch collider of object ground, it's called collision. Whenever a collision occur, when player touch any objects, event void on collision enter 2D will be triggered. It will return variable collision, is object that player standing on. When player stands on any objects, variable on ground is true. While collider of player is touching another collider, player is leaving and don't touch this collider anymore. Event void on collision exit 2D will be triggered. It means player will not stand on any objects, or not stand on ground. On ground will be false. Press play to see how it works. And watch value of variable on ground. To see if player is standing on other objects. Now try to press button as many times as you want. Player cannot multi-jump anymore. Player can jump only if he stands on a ground object. On screen view, let's create some more objects. Control D to duplicate this image. Resize it smaller. Then add collider on this object. Make sure this collider cover all the object. Copy one more. Make sure there is a small gap between two colliders of them. Press play. And try to walk on these objects. Player can jump on it now. But when you walk through the gap between them, variable on ground is false, and player cannot jump anymore. Until you touched another collider or another object. The reason is, collision enter and exit, occur at the same time. It enter touch this object, but exit another collider object. To fix this issue, we will not use onCollisionEnter anymore, because it can trigger one time only. We use onCollisionState2D instead. This event will trigger many times if player is still touching another object. Try to run it again. When player moves through the gap, the issue was fixed, and can do jump anytime as you want. Duplicate this object, turn it 90 degrees, and make it higher. Make it as a wall to block our player, not pass through this area. Make sure its collider cover all the object. Now try to play. When player stays close to this wall, he can jump normally. But if you watch carefully, variable on ground always true. So you can jump over the wall. The reason is, collider of player always touch the collider of this object. That's why on ground always true. To fix this issue, we will create another collider at player feet and do ground check at this feet only. On object player, create new 2D object. Name it player feet box cast. Go to screen view. Resize it smaller. And put it under feet of player. I will make another color for you see it easier. Create a collider for this object. We will do ground check with this collider only. If you pressed play now, player feet collider will block player. Try to turn on his trigger on this collider. His trigger will allow other colliders go through it. If player is close to wall object, player collider is touching the wall, but player feet has no way to touch the wall. Player feet box cast can touch objects under feet only. Now, let's add script to do ground check at player feet. Name it player feet box cast. Open it. Inside this script, first, remove all unnecessary code. Go to player controller script. Move all ground check events to player feet box cast. When player feet touch an object, on collision stay will trigger. And we need to turn on ground value to true. But variable on ground is on script player controller. Not inside script player feet box cast we are working on. As I mentioned in last video, player controller script is a component. Just same as rigid body component here. And to get component, we can use public variable to do it. Let's do same thing to get another C# script in player feet box cast. Create a public variable with type is player controller. And name it player controller script. I will remove these errors for now. Control S to save it. Make sure you added our script to player feet box cast object. Now you can add component player controller into this public variable. All you need is drop object player into this variable. It will automatically pick component player controller from object player and add it into our public variable. On player feet box cast, You already have player controller component. Now you can access and do anything on this player controller component. But you can get only public variables only. Private variables will not showed here. Now select variable on ground on component player controller. When player feet touch any objects, variable on ground will be true. Do the same for on collision exit. When player feet collision exit, variable on ground is false. Press play to test it. Player feet box cast didn't work yet, on ground always false. Reason is, our player feet box cast using collider with is trigger. So we cannot use on collision events. If collider using is trigger, when it collides with other objects, events on trigger enter and on trigger stay will be triggered. Replace it with onTriggerStay2D. Do the same for onTriggerExit. Press play to try it again. OnGround has turned on, player feet box cast has worked. It worked well on side touching. Player can jump on any objects. Player cannot jump over wall anymore. This time, try to jump close to a wall, and keep pressing button move as well. Player will stuck on wall, until you leave button move. To fix this, we need to apply a physic material on player collider. Create new physic material 2D. Name it non-stick, or any names you want. Set its value to 0 to remove friction. Make sure bounciness is 0. Now select object player. On his collider, we will add our new physic material into player collider. You can select it from the list of material, or hold and drop the physic material directly into option material. Let's try to run the game. Move player next to a wall. Jumping and press button move same time. The issue is fixed, player cannot walk on wall anymore. Our player has no friction right now. It will slide on any surface, even you don't press any buttons. Because your physic material has removed all friction. To fix it, on player object, create new capsule object. Scale it smaller. Make it in front to see it easier. This object will be new feet of player. From now, this is the only object will touch the ground. Add new collider for it. This collider has no physic material, so it will not be slippery. Now select player object. Turn on player collider. Adjust this collider not touch the ground. Make it above new feet, just a little bit is enough. All good to go. You can make player feet box cast invisible, and rename this object as player feet. Make it invisible too. And press play to see the result. No more slippery. Jumping works well. No stuck on side, or not walk on wall issue. When player falls to an edge of object, it will bounce a lot, even we set bounciness value is 0 on physic material. Because we use capsule collider, so it is a normal physic when it falls, but you can improve it, First, make player feet visible again. Then select player object, turn on capsule collider. Move bottom of this collider up more. So the edge of other object will hard to touch to this player collider. It will reduce the bounciness. Press play to see our final result. The issue was fixed. This will work on any terrains, any 2D or 3D games. Don't forget to subscribe my channel to save the video. Thank you for watching, and see you in next video.